Good morning, and welcome to today's edition of Stephen Whiteside's Stock Market Timing Television. Each day at this time, Stephen takes a technical look at the markets, including the S&P 500, NASDAQ, gold, crude oil, as well as the most widely held leveraged ETFs. This video is a production of TheUptrend.com and is for information and educational purposes only. The views and opinions expressed in this presentation are those of Stephen Whiteside and should not be considered personal investment advice. Always consult a qualified financial advisor before making any investment decisions. To learn more about the charts featured in this presentation, please visit TheUptrend.com. And now, here is Stephen Whiteside with today's video newsletter.
Good morning, Steve Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Wednesday, February 24th, 2010. In the pre-market this morning, we've got futures slightly below fair value. They've come off their overnight lows. European markets are mixed. Asian markets were down overnight. Starting off this morning, we noted that the short-term market breadth was up at the top of the range, and we were expecting the market to try to work off that overbought condition either by trading sideways or moving lower. Looks like we're starting to move lower. Midterm market breadth, the percentage of stocks trading above their 50-day moving average, has also started to roll over, so we are expecting lower prices here. Now, if we do get daily sell signals on the major indexes, which we don't have yet, if we do get them, the question will be, do we hold those previous lows from a couple of weeks ago? If we went down and retested those lows and started to move back up, that would be very bullish to see a double bottom there. Otherwise, if we go down and break those lows, of course, that would be a lower low, and that would certainly be bearish for the market going forward. Taking a look at daily charts for my five favorite stocks, Apple Computer is now on a daily sell signal. The CME Group, huge big sell signal yesterday. Google right on the cusp of a daily sell signal. For Goldman Sachs, a daily close below 153.75 on Wednesday would give us a sell signal. And for Research in Motion, which came right down to the lower channel line yesterday, a daily close below 68.10 on Wednesday would give us a sell signal for Research in Motion. Taking a look at some of the leveraged ETFs, for the ultras for the oil and gas sector, we're right on the cusp of a new sell signal. Any lower close on Wednesday would give us that. The ultras for the Qs, we need a daily close below 54. The ultras for the S&P 500, a daily close below 36.10. Ultras for real estate, which seems to be holding up fairly well right now, a daily close below 625 would give us a sell signal. The ultras for the chip sector, hard down day yesterday, right down to the bottom lower channel line, a daily close below 2948 on Wednesday would give us a sell signal. For the financials, a daily close below 536 would give us a sell signal on Wednesday, and a big reversal day yesterday for the financials. And basic materials, a daily close below 2970 on Wednesday would give us a sell signal. Now, looking at the indexes and futures contracts that we follow, sorry, I screwed up the chart here. We've got one thing hanging in, which is the U.S. dollar. Everything else has started to slide, and right down at the bottom of the list is still natural gas. Taking a look at the U.S. dollar, big reversal day yesterday, came down right to the lower channel line and moved up sharply into the close yesterday. Looking at crude oil, copper, gold, natural gas, they were all down yesterday. Gold looks like we might get a sell signal based on how we're trading in the pre-market on Wednesday. Looking at bank stocks, they were big reversal day yesterday. We had that sharp move up on Monday, a big down day yesterday. On Tuesday, we closed below Monday's low, so that is certainly bearish for bank stocks, even though we're still on a daily buy signal. Chip stocks came down hard yesterday. If we break yesterday's low, close below yesterday's low, that would give us a daily sell signal. Gold stocks now on a daily sell signal as of Tuesday's close. And the bonds moved up sharply yesterday, and any higher close on Wednesday would give us a buy signal for bonds. Taking a look at the 60-minute charts for Wednesday's trading activity, most of the major indexes came down, found support at the hourly flypaper channel on Tuesday. Looking at the panic zone chart, we're certainly projecting down just under 1080. There is support at 1080 with an open gap just below it, and certainly we would expect the market to try to find some support in the 1080 area. If that breaks, of course, that'll be a tell that we're going to go down and retest the recent low. Taking a look to the upside, we can remain bearish on the S&P 500 as long as we don't start closing above 1103 on Wednesday. We can remain bullish on the VIX as long as we don't start closing below 2090. Of course, a higher VIX is supportive for lower stock prices. Looking at the NASDAQ 100, and we can remain bearish as long as we don't start closing above 1809. And we can remain bearish on the SOX index as long as we don't start closing above 337.50. And for gold stocks, we can remain bearish on Wednesday as long as we don't start closing above 160 on an hourly basis. Okay, that's all for Wednesday morning, folks. Have a great day. We'll talk to you again on Thursday morning.
That was Stephen Whiteside with today's edition of Stock Market Timing Television. For more information on our charts and services, please visit theuptrend.com.